Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv, and it's Christmas Eve morning 2010, and I'm here to share with you Holiday Christmas Wrap Part 2. Now, the setup. First of all, I think I slept about 20 minutes last night. Why? Because I was trying to organize the set. I can refer to my home as the set, and wow, it was a mess. I officially just unpacked for my cruise, which I did about 2 months ago. Let me show you the raw materials. The raw materials of what we're working with for this Christmas season. Come with me. Come on. So here we have the pile of gifts that were purchased. They were purchased through Amazon as well as my local retailers. I enjoy shopping on Amazon.com as well as the local retailers. So all this crap. And it's not. I'm not in a very good situation here because the boxes haven't really been opened. I haven't really organized the gifts yet, so it's going to be a really messy wrap job. But let me show you the other part, the other component of wrap. Over here, I've amassed for the past 3 months all types of materials that I'll be using in creative and eco-friendly green wrapping techniques. So there you have it. But let me show you one more slow pan. As we go by the entertainment center that hasn't been completed, I've been working on that since April. But over here, yes, these are things I bought like the past year that I have not unboxed. Terrible. Of course you're gonna ask me, did you open up the iPhone 4? No! You wanna know why? I'm trying to keep a straight face on this one. I don't know where it is. It's somewhere lost in this mess. But let me show you about creative camera work, alright? Let's show you a very tight camera cut onto the living room set. Now look at this angle. Boy, the set looks pretty nice. Star map lit in all its glory in the beautiful sunlight. Anyway, let's start wrapping some of this crap with this crap. Nice. Alright, to start, we need to see that we have the proper supplies. Supplies. Alright. That's what a Chinese man says when he pops out from behind the door. Supplies! Anyway, let me show you the supplies. We have one big FF class roll of wrapping paper. So yes, everything is going to be wrapped with the same paper if I decide to use it. We have bows. We have the industrial packing tape. Industrial stapla, S-T-A-P-L-A. The box cutter. iPhones off to the side. And we do have the Logitech camera. And we are doing this live. We're streaming the filming of the video. Here is the proper use of the word streaming. I am not doing a webcast. I'm streaming the filming of the wrap part two. I'm not interacting with these people besides an occasional wave hello. Alright, anyway, on to the gift. So here's my Kodak ZI-8 camera that I never unboxed. I never unboxed it. And Dave the Marine and his wife Madeline are still filming with DV tape. So I thought this would be a great starter camera for them. You know, I'm really a big fan of these Sanyo Exactis. He's not going to film, you know, Lawrence of Arabia Part 2 with this thing, but it's a great starter camera for him and at least get him off of tape. So let me show you how I'm going to wrap it. I'm going to wrap it in the box for the Hop Hog HD PVR high def, you know, recorder. Now I hooked that thing in line with my entertainment center so I can do video grabs of the gaming sessions. Alright, I never, of course, finished the install. I never did an official unboxing, and I was actually going to do a reboxing, but who the F has time for this? So I want to do some recording of some gaming sessions. This is what was recommended for me from the company Hop Hog, their HD Hood Pervert. The Hood Pervert. And now the unboxing. There, it's unboxed. Are you all happy now? So I'm just going to use this box to wrap the Kodak ZI-8. Very simple. Let's just wrap it, and I'll show you the final product. So please stand by. All right, so the Kodak camera's in there, the extra battery's in there, and I'm also going to put in a bag of coffee beans that was packed when I bought a synthesizer from Nova Music that I bought in April of 2010 that I just opened up. So these coffee beans are kind of old, but what the F? It will buffer it. Now, you would think I would get something as critical as a 4 gig memory card. I say nay, nay. Why? Don't know where it is. So there you have it. To David Madeline from Cousin Alfred, a Hop Hog coffee wrap. Boy, that it looks actually quite nice and
totally confusing.
Big Madeline, Madeline Sr. I don't know if she likes to be called Big Madeline, whatever. She's a big fan of that Hallmark, Ballmark, Precious Moments crap. I picked her up some ornaments. All four rhymes with whore. Check them out.
So here's the first one. May your Christmas ring with joy. Well, that would be nice if Joy was a stripper and she was ringing the front doorbell at your house. Nice. Aw, baby's first Christmas. As long as it's not the baby's last Christmas, we're in good shape. All right, this one is, my hope is in you. If hope is the nickname for the sex toy, oh yeah. And the last one, home for the holidays. Depending on who it is, you might be saying, get the F out.
So there's the ornament lineup with the crudest and most vulgar jokes I can come up with on the fly. Literally pulled out of my rectum. Rectum, damn near killed him. Old joke, moving right along.
And we're going to wrap it in an Aldo shoebox. I've never seen this brand before. Wow, look at that. There's a special offer. Let's dance. Submit your dance video at www.aldoshoes.com/dance. High score wins $2,500. Boy, you imagine? Let's take a look at the shoes I bought. And there you have it. Aldo shoes. They kind of look like something out of Back to the Future. That's why I bought them, because they look kind of futuristic and alien. They're probably not very comfortable and probably do little to no back support, but they look good, and that's what it's all about. Nice. Look at this. Is this great or what? They're pretty secure in there, and just like a perfect fit. A little industrial tape, a freaking bone, a label, and I'm done. Nice. Let's dance. No. So there you have it. I kept the functional handle in place. Very nice. Green bow. Nice against the white, augments the red, very Christmassy. I covered up the dough in the Aldo logo, so just as Al. That should be confusing when they're handing it out. And to Madeline Sr. from Cousin Alfred, an Aldo ornament wrap. We actually disclose what's in the box, but do I really care? I say nay, nay. Let's wrap another. Senior family member Nancy also enjoys this Hallmark crap. I have a Harry and David box that had, like, fruit in it. Yo, really tough decision at the office when you got piles of, like, Godiva dark chocolate, chocolate-covered pretzels, chocolate-covered this, chocolate-covered that, and then fruit. Oh, gee, what do I want to eat? Gee, heart-healthy dark chocolate-covered stuff or the fruit? The fruit went into freaking garbage. Come on. I saved the box. Let's wrap it. Of course, each piece very carefully selected for the recipient. Precious moments. And this one is called, You Have a Special Spot in My Heart.
She had an electrocardiogram. The freaking spot could be like a blocked artery. I don't know. That was the bad joke. That was the best I could do. Let's see the other one.
Angel of Mercy. Yes, please let me last at least another 15 Christmases. Nice. So this garbage, probably made in China, fits real nice. I was able to use the springy thing in there. And there it is, with extra industrial packing tape for her arthritic fingers, though I'm not too far behind with my left hand because of the freaking ice display at 9 degrees. And what's the label say? To Nancy from Harry, David, and Alfred, a fruity collectibles wrap. Beautiful. Shit.
And there you have it. Jingle Bells, played incorrectly on the Korg Oasis. It's like the first time I've powered it up in about 8 months. Wow. Senior family member Aunt Fran gets a Precious Moments also. I mean, it's real great. I walk into that store and I do a triple all in one shot. Just like the triple bypass I'm going to need from the freaking 2 fruitcakes I ate over the past 3 days. It's true. Anyway, let's take a look at the piece.
This is a Walt Disney showcase piece. Ooh, yeah, because of the Walt Disney branding, they get to, like, bang an extra $20 for the damn thing. And, this is like a music box. The figurine basically, she has a pole up her ass. She spins around and plays some songs, which is kind of nice.
And here we have a beautiful statue of a ballerina, but we also have the physical representation, literally, of a pole up the ass.
So we'll box it into a wine.com box. That makes a lot of sense. Look at how nice that looks. Look at how nice that is. To Aunt Fran from Alfred, start drinking wine wrap. She really should start drinking wine. It'd probably help her get some sleep. And notice, as of yet, I haven't touched one piece of wrapping paper. That's right.
I'm helping to save the planet. And New Jersey. This year, all little Julian wanted was the Hot Wheels Criss-Cross Crash. Criss-Cross Crash. Can you say it fast three times? Criss-Cross Crash. Criss-Cross Crash. Criss-Cross Crash. Whatever.
From the great Amazon. Criss-Cross Crash with the extended extra cars, which is really good. Let me show you the label I have in store for this. Just look at how beautiful and festive that is. A red bow to complement the red background and the word toys. To Julian from Uncle Alfred, it's a texting whilst driving rap. Remember, it's called Criss-Cross Crash. And where's it made? China! So, Rich Sr., one of the Toy Story trilogy. Here's the 10-disc set. Toy Story, Toy Story 2, and Toy Story 3, the ultimate Toy Box 3 movie collection. This is really very handy because what he can do with this,
he can stick the little brats in the multimedia room unattended for hours while I watch this stuff. Look at the label.
The beauty here is in the label. To Rich Sr. from Cousin Alfred, Toy Story XXX, Girls in Ecstasy. Woohoo! Now, nothing screams the meaning of Christmas better than CDW. Now, what you might think
is that the CDW means Computer Discount Warehouse. I say nay, nay.
It stands for Christmas Does Wonders. Nice. Christmas Does Wonders. Yes, it does. It makes people smile and happy and everything else. And also clog arteries and gain about 10 pounds. I'm sure I will. This is what Gianna wanted. She wanted the Dairy Queen Blizzard Maker. The Dairy Queen Blizzard Maker. So there it is. And that's going to be kind of fun. And I'm sure Mike and I and Dorothy and the rest of the crew will eat some of this stuff too. All right, so it's easy and fun. Add ice, salt, and water. 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 How do you phonetically spell it the way I say it?
Water. W-A-T-A. Moving right along to step two.
Pour in the desert mix and 0.5 and 0.5. And then what the F? Stir? Stir?
You don't hit a freaking button and then this crap pukes it out? You gotta stir it like back in the Stone Age? A few years after Aunt Fran was born?
This guy is teasing the hell out of me.
You gotta stir it. That's messed up. I'm sorry. This should have like a car battery.
There's the backup battery for my Corvette. I should wrap that with this piece of shit. Yeah, stir. For how long? How many hours you have to stir it to make one serving? Not four servings? No, it's step four, rhymes with whore. It's like stir for 3 hours until a kid complains, my arm hurts.
My arm hurts.
Very smart marketing. They use the razor blade type model. You gotta buy these packets of powdered crack to put into the machine to give it flavors. So, I guess I'll be buying this stuff for a while, or until the handle breaks, which will probably be after three servings, but whatever, the kid will have fun. Nice. And we'll eat it. Even nicer. Where's my cholesterol pill? Oh, right there. I'll take two, please. Two scoops? No, two cholesterol pills to offset the two scoops. Okay, and the final label in a very uneventful box to Gianna from Uncle Alfred. Make Daddy an alert wrap. Let me explain the story.
We were all in Dairy Queen. Dorothy, her husband Michael, and Gianna, who was about 3 or 4 years of age at the time, and myself. Mike's always the last one to order, and he always takes the longest time. He's always looking at what everyone else ordered, and no matter what happens, whether you're at a restaurant or an ice cream shop, when he sees what everyone else got, he says, "Oh, I should have got that." So he really scrutinizes the menu, really takes his time, and And at that point in time, Dairy Queen was advertising new flavors. So they had the word alert, and then under the word alert, they had a listing of all the new flavors and combos and whatever they had. So Mike is like looking at everything on the menu up on the wall. And like his wife says, you know, Mike, come on, gives him like a snarl. And Mike, like, you know, he says, oh, okay, you know, give me the alert. Now, under the word alert was like a mint chocolate chip blizzard. All right. So Mike, but you know, the word alert was there to bring your attention to that part of the menu. Anyway, under pressure from his wife's snarl, Mike says to the guy behind the counter, give me an alert. And the guy is revving up to like laugh at him. And I take my fist and I bash it down on the counter and I say, give the man an alert. The man wants an alert. Make him an alert. This guy almost shit his pants. I didn't want Mike to be embarrassed. And then when he got the ice cream and we went back to the parking lot, I said, Mike, I got to explain why I exploded like that. And we were all laughing. So the joke is, the tongue-in-cheek joke is, let's go get some ice cream. Yeah, Mike, let's get alerts. All right, so now Gianna can make an alert for Daddy at home while she cranks the freaking handle and breaks her arm. Gabriella, that sweet, innocent little child.
It's the holidays. Smile, sweetheart. Smile. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Who I nickname my little vortex of evil. She handpicked these items sitting on Mommy's lap. She said that Mommy told her that I spoke with Santa Claus and that everything was good and she can pick what she wants. Makes it real easy. She knows what she's getting.
And we have the very special Disney press-on nails. I was going to keep these for myself. And this, I don't even know... I don't know what it is.
Barbie Storyteller Clock Radio. This would be like really good to, you know, wake me up in the morning. Of course, there was one other set of nails that she wanted. 9-inch nails. It says on the Amazon shipping status that it shipped. Oh well, I do stand corrected. I saw a box from drugstore.com. I thought it was like supplies for my CPAP system.
You have witnessed the dark side of the Force. Rule the universe with me by my side as father and son.
That's pretty good, right?
Yeah, you're kind of crazy.
It's the missing girly nails. So she's getting all four... Yes, she's getting... Should we edit this? Yes, she's getting all four things that she wanted. Why do I have a problem saying that? All four things. All four things. Yes, she's getting all four things that she wanted. Whatever. There it is, to Gabriella from Uncle Alfred, a Pink Princess Sketches wrap. I actually tried putting in some industrial staples with the stapler gun, S-T-A-P-L-A, but it didn't hold. So she'll have an easy open on this one, unfortunately. Of course, I could cover up the SH and make it an ape up, or even better, cover up the S-H-A and just make it a P-up. That's funny. Because like, there's like a little droplet of urine coming out right after the E. I mean, it makes sense. It does. And it's funny. It is. Laugh. Put comments. And laugh. L-O-L. R-O-T-F-L? Is that rot flower? Rot Florida? Whatever. Not impressed. Little Sabrina wanted Dora.
Yeah, Dora. Because it rhymes with...
Dora?
Knock it off.
She heard you, bitch. She's coming over.
You think I'm going to wrap that? No. No. Here's the wrap job. I'm just shoving the freaking paper back in and put tape in a bow, and it's done. Because I'm really running late. And yeah. Fine.
To Sabrina from Uncle Alfred, Dora the little whore, It's nice. It's very festive, and it works. Horror does rhyme with Dora. I mean, I don't really see a problem with that. The kid's four. She's not going to get the joke. For Vincenzo, for his Wii system, Toy Story 3, the game, and the very much anticipated, and what I hear, a pretty cool game from Disney. This game is called Epic Mickey. Why do I have a brain fart? Disney's Epic Mickey.
And Mickey looks a little kind of pissed off and evil or something. I don't know. It's supposed to be a pretty interesting game and very creative. I know why my speech is all messed up. It's not because of a pending stroke. It's because I had zero sleep. I think I rested for about like 20 minutes. I think I look pretty good for not sleeping. I only slept for about 20 minutes. I don't really consider that much REM sleep. Unless, of course, you're listening to like REM the group, and then I guess technically if you were just nodding off for a few minutes, that would be REM sleep because you were playing the REM CD in the background. But who the hell plays CDs anymore? The REM MP3 in the background that you purchased from the iTunes store. Yeah, sure. Now look at this festive box. The Adobe Creative Suite 3 Master Collection designed across media with Adobe Acrobat 9 Pro. Yes, I bought the software. I bought the Creative Suite Master Collection. Yes. Yes, and I'm going to use the box because I really don't use the software much. And look, what a lovely fit. It's like it's like art. It's like, yeah, if I can get the, yeah, but it, yeah, I wasn't good at Legos, and this is, yeah, okay. You think I'm going to keep the camera rolling? Let's see how long it takes you to put the friggin' top on with one hand. I can do so many other things with one hand. Come on, there. Where's the window? No, I was going to do the Windows, ta-da, but we're still rolling. Good thing this is an 8mm film, because right, obviously, a total fail. I can't get the friggin' thing on. Yeah, there it is, a Windows, ta-da, and if it was 8mm film, I would be filming with this, my father's Bell & Howell 8mm 8mm, M-I-L-L-I-M-E-T-A, millimeter, 8mm camera, film camera. I think it was 1.5 minutes a side, and then you had to flip the thing over to get the other half, 1.5, so it was like 3 minutes, and you had a crank handle to crank the thing, and you threaded, wow, that was like dirt, you threaded the film, into the device. You went under like a shady tree while, you know, my mother was yelling at him, hurry up, Al! And then you wound the crank. Debbie dropped this when she went to Italy. It went down went down the stairs somewhere in Rome, but you crank the handle. Again, I'm trying to do it with one hand. And then you press the button over here. Listen to it. And that's the way you film. There was like the UV protector, and here was the selector based on how bright or dark it was outside, just to control the exposure. But I'll tell you what was good about having this 1.5 minute constraint by having this, and this is all metal. This thing is heavy. It's really a beautiful piece, and I'm so glad I did bring it down with me. It brings back a lot of nice memories. My father did a fair amount of filming, which we converted over to videotape. But I'll tell you what was interesting about the time constraint. You only had 3 minutes. So you didn't just leave your finger down on the button and just film everything. You took short clips, short 15, 20, 25-second clips, 15-second clips of what was important, of what was critical. And then basically, you know, when the film was processed, you had a 3-minute montage, you know, that was pretty watchable. So, I mean, it worked. You know, it worked. And even though the resolution isn't very good compared to what we have now, it's still great that we have whatever resolution we have. It's really pretty interesting. And look at how nice that looks. What a lovely looking Christmas gift for little Vincenzo. So to Vincenzo from Uncle Alfred. And the label says, don't break the TV with the Wiimote wrap. You know, I mean, it's inferred, even though it's not there. So there you have it. Nice. I'm going to do the exact same thing I did last year. Use the Omaha Steaks box. This time I'll refer to it as a sarcophagus wrap, because when Mike Sully heard me reference the sarcophagus wrap, he spit up his food. Mike, I hope you're watching, and I hope you spit up your food. I'm doing a sarcophagus wrap with the Michael Jackson crap. Here we go. And yes, Michael, you return to your lowest state of entropy, which is like no motion or death, if I got the physics right. Maybe I didn't, but there it is. An official sarcophagus wrap. I'm doing like the animation, like slowly putting it on there. You get it? Like a sarcophagus, a little tape, a bow, and a sticker. We're done. Wow, the box just like farted. To Michael from Cousin Alfred, MJ sarcophagus wrap. Mike's gonna have trouble with that word when he tries to read the label. Well, we'll see. We'll see if he tears up. Cousin Rich Jr. is getting Call of Duty Non-Caucasian Ops for the Xbox 360 and the Tron soundtrack by Daft Punk. It's very good. Wow, what a novelty for Rich to have like a CD. I mean, he does digital downloads, but yeah, I still buy CDs. I'm old school. And what is it going in? It's going to go into an Abercrombie, and I have trouble with that one. Abercrombie, an Abercrombie and Abercrombie and Fitch bag. And you'll see the joke with the label. Get a Rich Jr. from Cousin Alfred, a six-pack solid nutrition wrap. And certainly, that's an abdomen that both he and I certainly don't have. Boy, can't wait to eat when I get to the family's house today. Now, Dave the Marine, he was indeed in active duty in Iraq. See, I said it with a straight face. I said active duty. And, you know, he does from time to time have flashbacks, so I enjoy giving him Christmas gifts that help induce flashbacks. Help induce flashbacks. Things like Medal of Honor. Nice. But I'm putting a little extra stocking stuffer in the box. Here's the box. The hot gel shaver doohickey from Con Air, which I actually use and I actually like. But let me show you the stocking stuffer. These are the towels that they handed out on December 19th, 2010, and the game was Dolphins versus the Buffalo Bills. Miami's Dolphins versus the Bills, and we lost another crappy home game. I think they only won one home game to date. What can you do with this freaking thing? What do you do with this? This towel, this rag, should be used as like a hemorrhoidal wipe. That's all it's good for. Win some freaking games.
And the Dolphins are getting booed.
Chad Henne, you're a sack face, all right? Because you got sacked. And let's do one more from the vulgarity generator here. Let's do a random one. Here we go. All right, Chad Henne, you're a sack. You're a sack skank. I kind of like that one. What else we got? You're a sack beater. That's pretty good, too. And a sack jammer. Nice. And there's the final product. Today from Cousin Alfred, a flashback-inducing Xbox gel wrap. And looks like a Smurf is, like, spooing in this guy's hand. Whatever. Madeline, Teresa, Dorothy, and Maria are also getting the... fucking name of that crystal. The whatever. You know what I'm talking about. The crystal. All right? I really have trouble saying the name. It really is beautiful. It's a beautiful piece. And a few other people are getting it as well as gifts from me. It's really quite brilliant. And they come out with a piece every year. Swarovski. It doesn't say... Swarovski. The sw... See, I want to get sw... Now I gotta rewrap it. Now I'm gonna hand these four to the ladies. Do you see the little personal touch? The subliminal I put on there? The sticker? You see that? Alright? And the joke will be, will they put it together and say, hey, is Alfred calling us hoes? We'll see. Alright, so I put those four in my small white sack for distribution purposes. Nice. Yeah, you can see a little bit of the hoe kind of coming through my sack. That's right, something new for 2010, Wrap 2010 for Alyssa. I also got her a gift card for the Simon Mall. How do you spell mall phonetically the way I say it? M-A-U-L, mall. Going shopping at the mall, all right? There you go. Let me show you how I'm going to wrap this, because the theme here is that I want her to do some power shopping. It's an FF class card, all right? But take a look how I'm going to wrap it. For power shopping, indeed, it will be wrapped in a APC backup UPS model 350. Is that great or what? Of course, the biotoxic lead acid battery was properly disposed of first. Threw it off the balcony. So by now, you might be saying, Alfred, where are you going to put the card? I'll show you. You flip it over, and there's a slot. you throw it in. And that's it. A little industrial packing tape. Beautiful. Come on. Look at the dangling visual here. Come on. Does this scream Christmas? Does this scream peace and love? Does this scream birth of Christ? Come on. If that doesn't do it, what does? You tell me. Well, the bow freaking fell off. Oh, pesky bow? Never a problem. Never. Just a nice piece of industrial packing tape over the bow, and then you smash it down a few more times. There goes the arthritis in my effing hand. There it is. Beautiful. That was the right chord to end it on, that one. Yeah, whatever. Okay, for the party host, Rich Sr., little gray goose, for his private stock, for his private staff. So the man's been making his own beer and wine. It's always nice to give him a little bit of, some extra stuff so he can stay tanked up during the holidays. I don't know, whatever. The man doesn't drink water. Rich Sr. doesn't drink water. He drinks beer. He's in pretty good shape, though. Definitely leaner than me. All right, let's see what else. Something for the other hostess. Madeline, his wife. Like Jane, his wife. Madeline, his wife. Too many syllables. All right, let me show you what I got her. It's from Godiva, obviously. And it's a box of Godiva dark chocolate assortments. Dark chocolate assortments by a freaking speech therapist. All right, so there it is. And it's heart healthy. Wow, what a crock of shit that industry has gotten over. Oh, yeah, heart healthy. Yeah, yeah, too bad people eat like a ton of it. It has fat, sugar, carbs, whatever, but it tastes good. But this is too good. I mean, it's in a nice Godiva bag. It has nice Godiva, rectal paper, whatever. How do we make this like an Alfred.TV gift, though? I mean, This is too blasé, no pun on my parcel of my last name. It needs a little twist. How do we F it up? Follow me into the kitchen and I will show you. My buddy Jace turned me on to a new store, at least new to me, called British Depot. Get this out. A bunch of Brits selling like UK stuff in these little stores. Look what I bought. I bought like the real shit. I bought like Weetabix. And this mint jelly crap and this stuff I dumped on the steak that I inhaled while I was like filming. And the actual guts of like the mince pie from 1881. Yes! 1881. They had a fucking time machine. Is that nuts or what? They went back in time to 1881 and brought back a jar of that shit. Amazing. But look what else I picked up. Looks like a freaking tombstone. A Lewis and Cooper handmade fruitcake. What? Handmade. Oh, they didn't outsource this to China? Okay, good. But that's what we're putting in the bag, all right? That's what's going in the bag of the Godiva chocolates. A fruitcake. As I said before, I'm not embarrassed. I like fruitcake. It's really, you gotta give it a try. You gotta give the good stuff a try, though, like the Claxton brand. There's a few others that I've been inhaling. I ate two effing fruitcakes. Diet and exercise program starts January 2nd. I want to be cliche, like everyone else, into the gym like a friggin' herd of cows, January 2nd. Nice. Let's put the fruitcake in there. Oh, she's going to really flip when she sees it, and I'm definitely going to eat some when I get there. Nice. And there it is. Wrap 2010, part 2. Might even be part 3, because I still got more stuff to send up. It will be after Christmas, though. But here's the full panoramic view of the wrap job. And as a whole, head like a hole, as a whole, boy, it looks like shit. It really does. But then again, the recipients know that I indeed took the time and trouble, over 3 hours, to wrap and film this crap for you all. So there you have it. All right.
Oh, crap. I'm doing an inventory SKU spot check on the way out. I forgot the present for Alice and Teresa, the Nightmare Before Elm Street stuff. Check it out. It's a "What's this, Jack?" head knocker, and he's giving, like, the Italian, like, a fungul, and a Jack and Sally wall clock, which I think is actually really pretty cool. They like this stuff. So what I'll do is I'll just drop it in a Ballmark bag, and there it is. Wrapped and absolutely functional. Alfred from Alfred.TV. I got a nice grease worked up. Don't knock the grease. It keeps the wrinkles away. Star map in back of me. Say it's not art. I don't give a shit. I love it. More to come. Stay tuned. My presents integrate so well under the Christmas tree. Am I right? And such a beautiful LED tree. I'm monologuing over my video, Madeline. Knock it off. Alyssa.
Wow, it's a UPS. That's how I get it. Wow.
Alyssa, we're asking for a battery. You're asking for a battery?
I don't know how to open it.
Wow. That's cool. I think you may need a box for it or something.
Yeah, something, you know, down there. No, you're in the right area. Just you know, work at that table. There's a panel over there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, this is yours.
Who's paper?
Who's paper is the green paper?
Very, very innovative. You like the wrapping?
I like it.
Yeah, no, I think it's good. There you go. And then you get it work. There you go. Yeah, press that in. Got to get all that tape off, though, babe. I think you got it now. There you go.
These are all excited over here, opening up the gifts that we got from Santa and everybody else's family.
Thank you.
Is that good?
Yeah.
It's innovative, right? See, that's it. So it's $100. So you can do power. You can do power shopping. Get it, power. You know, it's a power. You get it, power shopping. There you go. You're welcome, sweetheart.
Hold on, who could it be? And you. Here he is!
Okay. Wait, let's do our commercial again. Wait a second. Keep that rolling. This is live. Wait a second. We're gonna change it a little bit.
And he's here to buy some of Debbie's Mary Kay.
Hi, my name is Al.
Hi, my name is John.
And we have an eating disorder. That's why we White Castle.
Microwaveable hamburgers.
So we can look like Tommy Lasorda. He's a fantastic.
We're gonna cut this one now. But there's Deb once again playing Mary Kay.
There's my Fudigan Butterfinger.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.